So, yeah, so we don't have a set list anymore. Well, we just play whatever seems to make sense. And we try to, if you've seen us before, I don't know if you have.
Woo!
We try to, yay!
We've got one fan out there! Woo! Yes, it's a fan of Texas, Laura!
We love you!
Oh, Laura!
Woohoo!
There's at least two.
Yeah. Woohoo! Yes! Yes, multitudes of fans. If we try to tell jokes. The jokes are generally horrible. So don't
expect good comedy out of us. We did, Anna and I did take some improv classes. Not sure if it did be good, but.
Yes, but is improv actually ever funny?
No, you said yes, but you broke the number one rule of improv.
Yes, and improv is never funny.
Yes, and improv's not funny.
Yes, and neither is our show.
So.
Anyway, so that sort of worked. Anyway.
We tried. That's all you can ask of us right now.
Alright, this is a very powerful and important song with the, I don't know, some sort of message. Probably not. It's about the existential battle between drag queens and trans ladies.
Kind of like West Side Story, only a lot more queer.
Like about the rumble.
Anxiety and QT.
I mean, it does. Well, I think
we're going to switch from a song about Gen X to a song that mentions Gen Z.
Oh, that's true.
Yes.
All
right. Yes. We came up with it yesterday, thank you.
Unfortunately, I didn't remember it, and then Jen had to whisper it to me.
I can't say it because it won't be funny if I say it.
Your brain won't leave you alone.
your brain, I like to call it anxiety in the key of G.
Indeed. And in fact, I remembered my riff.
Oh, did you?
Okay, so unlike Eddie, who we love, by the way, thank you so much, who makes up complicated songs in many keys, we mostly just play in the key of G because why not?
CCR has a specific key that they like.
It just makes me, it's like, what key is the song? Oh, it's in G, ready.
Okay. Maybe we should play one in A, though, just to change things up. Maybe we should sing a song about Uncle Willie.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, Uncle Willie, all right.
That's not a euphemism.
Or maybe it is.
Thank you.
themselves seriously.
I mean, sometimes we do like alternate Thursdays.
Right, once like, in a blue moon.
Once or twice a year.
That one time there, yeah. Anyway, that song is about the organ formerly known as my penis.
Not to be confused with the artist formerly known as Prince.
Slightly.
No, I can see how there could be some confusion. No.
Please don't say both were purple. I don't know.
No.
I got her drinking.
Sorry.
Down the wrong pipe. So we like to sing a lot of songs about what we know, and a lot of that is queer identity songs.
Yeah. So, Jen, are you ready for your queer identity song?
Finally. We finally figured out who I am. This song was written in the summer of 2020 when I just had major orthopedic surgery and I was blitzed on my mind on Percocet. So it seemed like a really good idea to write a song about my sexual identity. Well, she walks into the bar.
Take me just the way I am.
I mean, Jen, you don't eat seafood, so. She literally does not eat it. That's not
normal. I'm really surprised nobody's made a shellfish joke yet.
We didn't make it.
We didn't promise good.
They're throwing us a joke.
Alright, so how far are we through the show at this point?
I mean,
like, we got plenty of stuff to play. Yeah.
How about we do something real weird?
Let's do something weird.
Here I go. I go. You're giving it away, people.
Sorry. Okay.
All right.
It's a surprise.
Sorry, you just changed that yesterday.
One.
No.
It works. Okay, good, yay.
The kazoo's funnier.
This is only the second time that we've ever recorded.
Maybe we'll layer it and I'll do it
in a recording.
Maybe.
So look, what time do we end? 10 is that the 9:50?
Shirtless karaoke guy has no relation to any song, totally different meaning. In fact, like almost like had Eddie been the shirtless karaoke guy,
we wouldn't have written this song.
So, Ed
and I are just karaoke aficionados, and this
Those
is
go.
That's
how we all met. Was from
yeah, and this song was inspired by a person at a certain all day, every day karaoke establishment in the city. This is a real guy.
1, 2, 3.
Thank you.
So, all right, now let's see. How about a song about that feeling of just
existential dread? The feeling that I will have on Tuesday morning when I clock into work.
Yes. And then I'll have tomorrow morning.
I mean, it's supposed to be funny, but anyway.
Yeah. in an age transsexual thing.
Unintentionally super gay. This song was like almost banned by country radio because everybody thought it was a lesbian song, but it's actually a song about the other woman. But if you want it to be a lesbian song, it can be.
You know, who's to say that the person is singing to isn't also a woman?
Exactly.
Hey, to admit it, but I got a hurt.
church over there. Come and talk to us. We're friendly. And you
thank
know.
You to the Lost Church for
yeah,
having
thank
us
you,
here.
Thank you for Eddie for playing with us.
Yeah.
It was a pleasure.
Thank you, love your song about your little pug.
And thank yeah. you to you, the audience, for coming here in
yes,
this
thank
shitty,
you for
shitty weather.
During this freaking atmospheric
year. Yeah. This show has been 3 years in the making. We booked this show pre-COVID, then like all that happened, they changed locations, all this, so we are so excited to be here
finally
tonight.
Do this.
All right, so thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.